In this Blender tutorial, I'm going to show you how to bake textures from one UV map to a different UV map. So why might you want to do this? Well, recently I created this apple tutorial and I showed you how to create these apples, but I want to upload the apple 3D models to Sketchfab. And also, if I wanted to use these apples in a real-time render engine, or maybe I wanted to use them in a game engine or in a different 3D software, then I would need to bake the textures because these apples are using a apple texture, but then I'm also using some procedural textures like this color ramp to edit the colors. And then I'm also using a noise texture, a procedural noise texture. But if you want to add these apples into a game engine, or maybe you want to upload them to Sketchfab or something like that, then you can't use procedural textures because procedural textures only work within Blender. So you have to bake out all the textures to texture maps. The problem with this is that I've already UV unwrapped the apples. And so if I try to unwrap them again, like I'm just going to press U and do the smart UV project, you can see that now it's going to mess up the apple texture because it's using a different UV map. So what I want to do is I want to create a separate UV map. And I want to create one that's better for like a game engine, so I don't want to have any overlapping or anything like this. And then I want to bake those textures from this UV map to the other UV map. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to the shading tab, and then I'm going to click right here and drag down, and then I'm going to change this to the UV editor so that we can preview our UVs. Now what we need to do is we need to create a new UV map. To do that, I'm going to click right over here on the object data properties, and then there are some different tabs here. You're going to open up the UV maps. Now right now, this UV map is the default one that we're using, and if I open up this apple texture in my UV editor and then tab in edit mode, you can see that it's using this UV map, but I want to create a new UV map. So to do that, I'm going to click on the plus right here, and that's going to create a separate UV map. And I'm just going to call this one UV map 2. Now, if you scroll right over here, you can see that you can actually choose what UV map you want to look at. So here's the first UV map, and then here's the second UV map. Now, right now they look exactly the same, and that's because when you add a new UV map, it copies the data of the old one. So now we can change this, and it's not going to affect the apple. So I can press U, and then I'm going to click on unwrap, smart UV project. And then for this, I'm going to do an island margin of 0.001, and I'll just leave everything else at the default, and then I'll click on OK. So that is a much more clean UV unwrap, and there's not any overlap or anything like that. So now I need to tell Blender to bake the textures to the new UV map. So to do this, I'm going to press Shift A, and I'm going to search for an image texture, just drop it down here, and then I'm going to click on new to make the texture that I want. So I'm just going to call this apple, and then I'm going to have it a 4K texture, and I'll just leave the color at 0, and I'll click on OK. So now if I click right up here and click on the apple texture, this is the apple texture that I'm going to bake the textures onto. Now to tell Blender to UV unwrap it to the correct UVs, I'm going to press Shift A, and I'm going to search for the UV map node. I'm just going to drop the UV map node right down here, and then I'm going to plug the UV up to this apple texture. Now we don't want to use the UV map because that is this one, that is the overlapping one. If you scroll right over here, you can see it's this one. That's not what I want. I want to change it to UV map 2, and that one, if you click right up here, that is the new one, and that is the one I want to use. Now this one over here, on default, it should use the first one, but just to confirm that, you can press Shift A, and again you can add another UV map. And I'm going to drop it down here, and then I'm going to change it to the first UV map, and then you can replace it for these textures. So instead of just using the texture coordinate, I'm going to replace it for this UV map, and then I know for sure that it's going to use the first UV map. And then this is a procedural texture, so this one is just plugged up to object, and that is totally fine. So now we can just bake the textures. So I'm going to go right up here to the render properties. Now right here on the render engine, you need to change this to cycles because Eevee doesn't support baking. But if you are using Eevee, you can change it back to the Eevee render engine once you're done baking, but just change it to cycles. Now I did make a tutorial on how to do texture baking in Blender, and some people were saying in the comments that you can use your GPU for texture baking, but I found that CPU just works better. So I'm going to change it to CPU. You could try using GPU, but I am going to use CPU because I found that works better. Now also right here on the render samples, it's actually going to use the samples to do the texture baking, because I found that if you turn this number way up, you turn the render samples way up, it's actually going to take longer to bake. And then if you turn it way down, it's going to be quicker. So I'm just going to change it to a 10. I find that that works fine for texture baking. And then go right down here to the bake and just open this up. So what you need to do is you need to make sure this is selected, make sure that apple is selected. Now to bake the color map, you could change it to the diffuse, but what you can also do is you can also just change it to the emission. And then I have the node wrangler add-on turned on. If you don't have that enabled, you can go edit and then go over here to the preferences. And then right over here under add-ons, you can just go to the search and you can type in node and just turn on the Node Wrangler add-on. And then we can just close the user preferences. So now that we have that add-on turned on, I can hold down the control and shift key and click on the color ramp. And that is just going to preview it, and it's going to use an emission to preview that. So if you change this to emission now, the viewer node is previewing the color. So then you can just select this, just make sure this object is selected and make sure this apple texture is selected. Then you can just click on bake and it's going to bake that image. And there we go. So you can see it finished. And because we set it up for the UV map 2, you can see that it didn't use the other UV map. It used this correct UV map. So then you can just save this image. You can just click on image and then you can click on save as and save this as an image texture on your computer. So baking it with the emission does work pretty well. You don't have to do that though if you don't want to. You can just control shift and click on the principled BSDF and just preview that. And then instead you can use the diffuse, and then we want to turn the direct and indirect lighting off because we don't want it to actually bake the lighting that is going on our object. We just want to bake the color. And then again, just make sure your apple selected or your object selected, and then make sure this texture is selected, and then you can just click on the bake button. So now let's bake the roughness. So I'm just going to click right here and I'm just going to change it to the roughness value. You could of course hold down the control and shift key and click on the roughness, and then again use the emission value. I'm just going to do the roughness one, so I'm going to change this to roughness, and then just make sure that the material output is going into the principled BSDF. Before you bake, you need to make sure that this object is selected, and then also make sure that this is selected, and then you can just click on bake. And there we go, so the roughness map finished baking. So then again, you can just click on image and then click on save as. And then the last one that we need to do is we need to do the normal. So on the bake type here, this time we're going to change it to normal. And then again, just make sure that you have the correct object selected and make sure that you have this one selected right here. And then once again, you can click on bake. And then once it's finished, you can click on image and then just click on save as. All right, so we finished baking all of the three textures, so we can now delete the procedural textures and we can add our new baked textures. So what I'm going to do is box select all of these textures right here and press X to delete them. I'm now going to press Shift A and I'm going to search for an image texture. And then what I want to do is I want to press Shift D and duplicate it three times so that there's three different textures, and then I can open up all the textures. So let's open up the first one, and I'm going to open up the apple green color, and then let's open up the second one. And then for the second one, it's going to be the apple green roughness. And then we can open up the last one. And the last one is going to be the apple green normal. So now that we have those all opened up, I want to plug the color one up to the base color, the roughness, I want to plug that up to the roughness here. And then this one, because it's a roughness value, we need it to be set to non-color data. And then the normal, we need to plug that up to the normal right here. And then again, because this one is a normal map, we need it to be set to non-color data. And then the last thing that you need to do is just press Shift A and you need to search for a normal map node and drop the normal map node right in here so that it converts it to normal data. So you can see that this texturing doesn't look correct, and that's because our Apple object is still using our old UV map. So if you just click right back here over on the object data properties, this is our old UV map. So we want to select it and then click on the minus here to get rid of it. So now we only have the new UV map, the UV map 2, and I can just change it back to UV map. You can just rename it. So then what you need to do is you need to just go out of rendered mode and then refresh it. Go back into rendered mode, and now you can see that it's using our new UV map with our baked textures. So I hope this video was helpful, and thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in a future video.